There's a new way to create an e-commerce website using StoreFront, WooCommerce and Elementor. This way you can create your own online store visually and with zero coding. This is the default StoreFront homepage, which looks awfully simple and anemic. In this video, I will be showing you how to make a much more impressive website, including a homepage and a contact page. So let's begin. Create a new page, call it homepage, publish it, and change the template to full width. Now I click on Edit with Elementor, which will bring me to the Elementor editor. I hide the title, begin with a new section. This will be our header section. Set the mean height to 100 ph, which means it's gonna spread around the full height of our screen. Now I added the content width, so my content will fit into a boxed shape. Drag in the first heading element. This will be our main heading. Now I'm gonna adjust it and give it much more presence by using size, weight, and color. Now I'm gonna give it a shadow with a darker shade of purple, and I'm gonna set the blur level to 0, which will make the shadow solid and it gives it this nice 3D effect. This will be our secondary heading. Now I will set an image to our background, which will give our background much more character. And I play around with the position and the size to choose an angle that will fit our header. I use this code to hide the breadcrumbs under the menu, which we don't need right now. Now on to the next section. This will be our product section, so I drag in the heading and adjust it. Now I will drag in our Woo products widget. Here I can adjust the number of columns, the number of products on display. I can reorder them by whichever way I choose. I can select featured products or the ones that are on sale, rearrange them by the rating or the popularity. For now, I will choose 4 columns. I will duplicate this whole section and choose to display only a specific category in the section below. And overall, this widget gives me much versatility and makes it very easy to achieve the exact goal I need. Now I can adjust the content width of the whole section, which will determine the size of my products. Now, this next section will be a call to action to view all the products on the website. I'm gonna duplicate the heading and set minimum height. I'm gonna drag in a button and call it View All Products. Choose a solid color as our background for now and by adjusting the style of every element, I will make this section come to life. I can also change the background to an image. I will choose a position and a size until I will come up with an interesting angle for the image and set it as fixed to get this nice parallax effect. I will set the background overlay, choose gradient, and this will make our background more subtle and put the focus on the content. I can also choose to paste a video instead of an image. This will make our section much more interesting and immediately grab the user's attention. Now I'm gonna save this section as a template for later use in our e-commerce website. Next up is the About Us section, so I'm gonna start off with two columns. Drag in an icon box, adjust the content, and I'll drag in another heading to put in a bit more details about our business, like the address. Notice I keep using our orange and purple colors, and this is to be consistent and keep up with the overall website's design. Now I'm gonna set some padding to our column and duplicate it 2 times. And this will give us this nice trio of 3 icon boxes. I'm gonna change the content and the icons. I'm gonna set a subtle border for the sides, which will further emphasize the separation between the columns. Now I will save this section as a template as well. Now we've actually completed our first homepage, which includes our products, and everything looks nice and beautiful. We can move on, but before we do, I want to make sure this page looks good on mobile devices. So I will switch to mobile view. And here I can adjust the settings of each element only for the mobile device. I'm gonna start off with the header and tighten everything up by adjusting the height, the paddings and the margin, and the sizes of the headings. For this section, I will set a fallback image, because on mobile devices the video doesn't play, so we'll have an image instead. Now our page is ready, it looks cool, and it is also mobile friendly. Next up, I'll add a new page, and this will be our contact page. Again, set the template to full width. I'm gonna hide the title. And I'm gonna paste in our previously saved section, and this will be our starting point. I'm gonna change the content, set an image as a background. I'm gonna play around with the positioning and the size to choose an interesting angle. And I'm gonna use social icons instead of the button. As you can see, saving templates and reusing them later saves us a lot of time. We can make small iterations here and there while remaining consistent with our design and still make everything look unique and original. Not to mention that it's much faster than starting from scratch. Again, I'm gonna use the code to hide the breadcrumbs. And once more, we're gonna paste in a previously saved template. We just change the icons in the content. Below this, we will create a subscribe section. Now I'll drag in a forms widget and customize it quickly so it will fit our website perfectly. Now our page is ready to go, all that's left is adjusting it for the mobile device. Once again, I'm gonna use padding, margins and sizes to tighten everything up. Now our page looks awesome and it is also mobile responsive. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Please subscribe for more awesome content. And this was Ilya from Elementor.